Now it is time. It's called put-up time. As Karen Anka steps in against Sigrid Schmuder from West Germany. 1,000 meters trying for her second goal. She has a gold and silver in hand. She won the 1,500. She was second at 500.
I don't think Karen's going to have as fast an opener as Rothenberger, but you can bet her last lap she's not going to die. She's going to put it to it.
Well, you may be wrong, because she is burning it. She's really on it and going very well, and she is ahead of Rothenberger's 200-meter split, Eric.
Well, a good fast 200, and you can bet that Karen Anka, who's also a good 1,500-meter and 3,000-meter skater, is not going to die in that last lap.
The emotions in a short race have to be so fragile that I would think you would spend more time at getting yourself emotionally ready, perhaps, than anything else. And I think we saw that reflecting from her as she warmed up this morning. Look at your 600-meter time. That's the fastest of the day.
She's got a lot of pressure on her, a lot of East Germans here cheering her on. It's going to be important that on this last inner, she sits back and concentrates on that turn, because that last inner is sometimes pretty hard to hold.
The time to beat. Scherner's 1:22.83. Both the East German women who skated earlier broke the Olympic record held by Petra Scherba at Lake Placid, and here it is. She's got it. 1:21.61. Anka posts the fastest time so far and breaks the Olympic record for the third time today.
Anka swings a little wide coming out of that corner, brings both arms down, and drives home really powerfully. Comes up a little bit high, but that's because she's tired.
This is Natalia Petrosheva now of the Soviet Union, who holds the world record in this event and held the Olympic record until they started skating today. Lydia Steffens of the United States is out there with her. Young woman from Northbrook, Illinois. Lydia on the left and Petrosheva on the right.
Well, this is a good pair for Lydia, because you can bet that Petrosheva is a little bit better skater, and it's really going to push Lydia to a good fast time.
Petrosheva, who won the bronze medal at 1,500 here at Sarajevo. She was sixth at 500 meters, and it looks like Lydia Steffens is holding right on to her, though you can see that Petrosheva is already at the end of 200 meters, beginning to pull away.
Lydia's looking good, stays right on that snow lane on the outer, has a nice arm swing, doesn't come above her head like Petrosheva's, but reaches out in front of her.
Natalia Petrosheva, who is now 28 years of age with a 7-year-old son and married to the trainer Anatoly, or the coach, has a degree from Moscow Institute of Physical Culture, and she would dearly love to have a gold medal to take home with her. Petrosheva's 600-meter split time. She's still in the hunt.
Well, she's got to pick up 1 second on that last lap, and I don't think she's going to be able to do it. Anka, to me, appears to be a much stronger skater.
Karen Anka posting the time to beat of 1:21.61. If it stands, she will have won her second gold medal to go with a silver. And really, the superwoman myth has not been broken as yet for Anka. Here comes Petrosheva driving across the finish. Not good enough. She is in there at 1:23.21. She breaks the old Olympic record, but she does not reach the mark of Karen Anka. Here's the finish again.
Well, Petrosheva had a good last lap, but now you know just how powerful Anka is. Petrosheva was 1 second behind, and now at the finish line ends up 2 seconds behind.
That's good enough, however, for a bronze medal for Petrosheva. It will be her second bronze in the Olympic Games, second gold for Anka, and Andrea Schroner gets a silver with Lalankova finishing fourth. As for the finish of the Americans, Lydia Steffens, Katie Klass, and Mary Doctor finished in those positions. Let's spend a moment with Leopoldis Muller, silver medal winner, 1,000 meters, Lake Placid, 1980 Winter Games. I know that you were interested today in how Karen Anka would handle the pressure. Not bad.
I didn't really have any doubts that she'd handle it very well, because Karen's a very established skater, and I think the mark of a true competitor is when they've got a little bit more pressure on them and they use the pressure to their benefit.
She has a chance now to win a third gold at 3,000. What about it?
Well, I think she's got a good chance at it, because she's coming off the 1,000-meter now, feeling good about herself, and it's just got to be to her advantage.
Thank you, Leah. Nice to see you.
Thanks, Keith.
Karen Anka, surely becoming one of the most celebrated athletes of her generation in East Germany. Many of her countrymen about Zetra today to cheer her on to victory, her second gold medal. She has won at 1,500. She took a silver at 500. She has a gold at 1,000. Wednesday, 3,000 meters.
Back here at our ABC Sports Control Center, we have some important sports news that's come in from back home. Sugar Ray Leonard's first comeback fight has been postponed. He was supposed to fight on February 25th against Kevin Howard. Today in Boston, he underwent his physical for that fight. Afterwards, the doctor said he had found some scar tissue and said preventive work was needed in one eye. The operation, they describe it as a minor operation, was performed tonight, but he won't be able to train for 10 days to 2 weeks. Ray himself is unavailable for comment, but the fight for now is off. That's the news from home. Very shortly, we're going to be going back to the Giants slalom competition and women's skiing up at Yacht Arena. Other things to come, so stay with us.